So you have your template ready, you have your EHR base instance running. So let's take a look at what we need to do next. So your next step would be to take a look at the API, the Airbase or OpenEHR API. So let's take a look at that. So this is the official OpenEHR API spec, and you can see the overview and all the different endpoints there are. So we will not be exploring it here. We'll instead be using our Insomnia client. So let's open that up. So in Insomnia, I have a collection here with all the different endpoints. So first we'll be taking a look at the OpenEHR REST API. So when you first get a template, the place where you post it is called the definitions endpoint. So this has a collection of different requests. So this is what you would be doing first. You'll be uploading a template using this endpoint, and you will have to put in your OPT file. So once you put your OPT file, you'll get your ID basically as an e-tag here. All right. Then you can just store that template ID somewhere, maybe as in an environment variable. So you can see that I have multiple environments set up here for EHR base, better, EHR DB. You can do the same. So you can also retrieve back your template given the template ID. So I don't have EHR base running right now. Let's just try the better CDR. And you get a 200 response back, and it's in the XML format. Okay. Now the compositions endpoint is how you get your compositions back. Now, when I was first getting started with OpenEHR, this was the place where I got stuck. I had a template, I had all of this, the server running, but I didn't know what to do with a composition. I didn't know how to create a composition. And this, I feel, is the hardest leap to make from having a template to making the composition. So I will try to explain it to you as much as I can, so you don't get stuck in this step. So let's come back to our screen. So compositions can be of multiple types. So what exactly is a composition? So the template is kind of like a schema. So you're telling what things you need. You're telling which archetypes should be there in the template. A composition is kind of like an instance of the template. So assume taking programming languages, a template would be a class and a composition would be an instance of that class. It will be an object. So that's kind of how you can think of a composition. And a composition can have multiple formats, and according to the OpenEHR official REST API, you only have two formats. So one is canonical XML, which looks like this, XML, and canonical JSON, which looks like this. So we'll be going in more depth on how to generate these canonical XML and JSON documents. But before that, I also want you to know that there are other formats for a composition. Although the canonical XML and JSON are the officially supported formats, we also have other more unofficial kind of formats. And that's where the EHR scape API comes in. So if you take a look at EHR base, so the root URL would be EHR base /v1/openEHR, right? So EHR scape comes in where you define another endpoint which takes in very similar API requests, but then they also have other features. So I'll show you what an EHR scape API looks like. So again, in the EHR scape, you have the same template API. You can list all the available templates you have, and you can, you know, upload your XML, but you can also get the web template. So this is kind of important because the whole Medblocks ecosystem works on web templates because it's also easier to read. It's easier to see what is going on rather than having a full blown OPT file. And other than that, some CDR vendors like Better or EHRDB also provide an example endpoint. Now, an example endpoint is basically you asking the CDR to give you an example of a composition so that you can change the data a little bit and then post it back. So that is available here. All you need to do is the the base URL /template/template/id/example. Now, this feature is not yet available in EHR base, but I'm hoping it would be someday, maybe. I'm just crossing my fingers. But yeah, this is already available in many of the commercial CDR vendors. Like if you take Better, for example, if I just ask it, give me an example, it just responds with this particular JSON object. Now you can also specify what format you want it. So right now this format is called flat, but you also have other formats like structured. So these two are the most widely supported non-official formats, and that would be flat and structured. So flat basically is just the path and then the value, and structured is a little bit more nested. So you have a path. I'll just show that here. So you can see that you have a path, but inside that you have another thing, and inside that you can have another thing. And in the end, the data kind of looks like this. So this is an ordinal. So it has a code value and an ordinal. The same thing in flat would look something like you would just have that in the same path. So you would just put a this or sign and then make it magnitude and unit. This is a quantity, for example. So these are the different types that are widely supported. So you have the canonical JSON, you have the canonical XML that are supported by the REST API, and then you have the flat structure and the structured, which is a little bit more structured and it's different. Although EHR base doesn't support this yet, so you'll have to go with flat form. All right. So there are also other types of compositions. So I'm just going to explain this to you so that you don't get confused when you do come across them and when you do see them. So do not, it's fine if you don't know how to create these formats. So the first one that I'm going to talk about is the Ethersis format. It's also, referenced in the official openEHR documentation. I'm just going to open that up for you. So in the, simplified data formats, simplified data template, you see this is the example that they mention. So the way this works is that it has the AQL path as the attribute and then the data here as the value. So the AQL path can also be used here. The way flat format works is a little different. It works by concatenating all of the IDs. So EHR base has a pretty good documentation for that. So here in the flat format, right, you just take a web template and you concatenate all of these IDs. You keep going like that, and that's how you get the path of the flat format. It's very similar in structured as well, except that you don't concatenate it, you just make it a nested object, right? So this simplified JSON thing, again, this is, it has different names, NCSTD, but I just call it the Ethersis format because Ethersis was the first systems to like actually support this kind of a format. Then this is the flat format that I was talking about. We also have the structured format that is documented here. They have a few, algorithms and things also that you can take a look at, but you don't really need to know about all of these. So in the next video, we'll take a look at how to actually create these compositions. So for now, just know that there are different types of compositions out there. Do not get confused between what is supported by what. I will also put a table at the end of this video explaining all the different types of compositions and which products support which. There is also one more format that you need to know about, and that is the EHR server JSON format. Okay, so if you go to Cabo Labs and you just log in, so we'll be doing this in the next video. This is how we will be creating our first composition. This JSON is not accepted by the opener server, by any official opener server. This is accepted by EHR server, and this is kind of like a transformation of the XML into JSON, and that's not official. This is not an official format. Only the XML is the official canonical JSON format. So this is not canonical, so just know that that exists and don't get confused by that. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll see you in the next one. I'll try to explain more in detail about these different formats and how to create them yourself. So here's the table of all the different openEHR products and the format that they support. You can see that Airbase supports canonical JSON, XML, and the flat format, but none of the others. And Ethersis, interestingly, supports the same, and it also supports Ethersis flat. EHR server supports canonical JSON, canonical XML, and canonical JSON is planned in the future and it will be released soon. And it also supports its EHR server JSON. Now the other products are all commercial products, and you can see what they support right here. So thanks a lot for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more videos like this. And if you have any questions, just put them down in the comments below or send me an email. It's siddharth@medblocks.org. And you can also check out our consultation services if you want long-term support. Just go to medblocks.org/consultation, and I'll see you in the next one.